Well, howdy, howdy, howdy. I am glad to be here. Hope you are too. I wanted to talk about this business as a part-time. Everybody's using that side hustle thing, and you could say the hot dog side hustle. But there are many vendors, hundreds of vendors. Just in our vendors group, Vendors United, there's members that are doing this as a part-time gig. Some of them only a couple times a year. We got one guy that does one event a year. We got a lady that does one event a year. She does the Rose Bowl parade. And so there's a vendor in Texas, another vendor in Texas, that does an event every year. He's got two of my carts and he sets them up and he's in a sea of food trucks and trailers, and he just does that one event a year, and that's all he needs. And when I say, you may be going, well, dang, that, how would he get by? Well, some of these vendors are making a ton of money. You take one of these vendors at the Kentucky Derby, okay? You're talking $250,000 a day. Now, you've got to split profits with the Derby and all this stuff, but you still are going to walk away with an annual income every day. And a good annual income, not a mediocre annual income. But let's talk about just the fact of part-timing it, kind of as a side gig. A lot of people got into side gigs during COVID, and people have been doing them for years. I know a cop that owns a pressure washing company, but he only works 2 days a week. I know one that does, another cop, it's a friend of mine that does, on the side, he does cleans cars, details, and he's a mobile detailer. Not a full-time gig. He just takes it when he can do it, and he sets all his appointments on the days that he's off. Well, it's because everybody wants that extra income to buy the new garage or the new boat or the new house or pay for the second divorce. So it comes down to what can you make, what's legitimate, what's accurate in what you can make. Well, I kind of have insight into that because I'm able to talk with thousands of vendors. And I work with thousands of vendors. And on a month-to-month basis, just a daily basis, in our Vendors United group, there's tons of vendors in there, and I get questions and comments and stories every day. So I find out what's moving and shaking. So we have vendors like Michael Wood. And if you've watched me at all, you've seen Michael Wood on here. I've been down and interviewed him. I've worked with him at an event or a private catering gig. He's just a good friend over the years. He was one of my first customers ever. Okay, he got a big dog cart, and then he got another big dog cart. And he was just part-time, 3 to 4 days a month. Okay, he had a full-time job. He's retired military now. And so he just did it part-time. We have another member that's in our group that is just retired in the military, part-time vending. Okay, he was part-time vending before he even got out. So what can you make, though? Well, if you set it up correctly, if you do it correctly, and you just go, you know what, I'm just going to focus on a good location 1 day a week or 2 days a month or 4 days a month. Well, you have the potential of 500 to 1,000 a day and more. I'm just giving you the averages. Okay, so not everybody's going to do that. And if you go, well, I'll just try this and I'll go down to My Ace Hardware and I'll set up in the parking lot, and you don't know what time to set up and you don't know what price plans and you don't know, have your menu right and your cart looks like crap because you didn't clean it the last time you used it, and all those things have an effect. But the bottom line is that a good vendor, one of our member vendors, will go out and have those $500 and $600 and $800 and $900 and $1,200 days. Well, you could do that 1 day a month. I mean, one day a month, and have you an extra $1,000 coming in. We've got some vendors, though, I want to tell you about something else, that do one event a month, okay, on average. Because in the summer and the fall, a lot of events, spring, summer, and fall. And in the winter, it slows down, so they don't work in the winter. So they'll do those 12 events, okay, during spring through fall. When it starts getting real cold, they're like, nah, not going to do it. And even though you can work in the winter, it's a pain, and there's not as many events. But I have filmed and showed you here, gone live, from vendors working ski slopes, vendors working in those cold climates, because there's not as much stuff out there. There's less competition. It's just a great environment for it. It's just harder on you. So these vendors, that do 12 events a year. And I'm talking on an average of $5,000 each event. So $5,000 for 1 or 2 days worth of work and do that 12 times. Well, now they've got a $60,000 income a year from vending part-time. So you talk about side gigs, that's the cream of the crop of side gigs. If you want to do it full-time, great. But we've had many vendors start off part-time. We've had lots of truck drivers and law enforcement and military start off part-time, 1 day a month, 2 days a month, and then go into full-time. Once that money, once you see, okay, I can do this. I could just stay home, do this 4 times a month, and replace my other income. And that's what it comes down to. So I just wanted to share that with you. I've gotten a couple questions in the comments here on YouTube, and I wanted to share it with you and let you know that it is absolutely possible to do a side hustle of hot dogs and make a good living, extra income. And I'm not talking, hey, I got a Pinterest page and an Etsy page and I make $4,000 every year, extra money. Yes, you can do that too. But, or you can go out to one event, you know, next month and or this month and hit you up $4,000, $5,000, $6,000, $8,000. So there's a lot of opportunity for you that will alleviate some of the cash crush. And it's so beneficial, especially in today's times, that you have some extra cash that you're not spending. Most of us, you know, most Americans are working paycheck to paycheck and still don't make ends meet or barely making ends meet. Imagine putting in 1 day a month, just 1 day, and making $800. 1 day. And when I talk about vending, let me say this before I go. I know I'm long-winded, but most people think vending is all day long, got to get out there and stay out there all day long. And there's vendors that do that, and they're rewarded for their efforts. But most vendors in America are vending 2 to 3 hours a day. That's it. 11 to 2. 11 to 1, some of them. And that's it. That's all they do. And they create this need. They create this scarcity, and people come to it. They go, oh, you got to catch Ben's hot dogs down there 11 to 1, or you're going to miss him. He'll be at the Piggly Wiggly on Thursday, and he's going to be at Tractor Supply on Friday. And so you will get more business because of that, because you're not out there all day, and it's a unique nostalgic item. So anyway, for that and a whole lot more, come over to Vendors United. Check it out. Have vendors that are actively doing this in all stages. From, hey, I'm thinking about getting into this and I want to cut out some learning curves and I'm going to join Vendors United, to the vendors in there that are making hundreds of thousands a year. So all of them, all the whole spectrum of vendors are in Vendors United. You can join. You can try it 100% free on me, okay? Try it, and it's at full access. You know how you go to these trial programs and they, well, you can't see this over here because that's for paying members, and you can't see this? No, everything is accessible during your trial. Try it out. And if you want to make it, this is your quickest path to making it. If I said, hey, path A takes you 6 years to know what path B gives you in 30 days, because of all those learning curves that you get to avoid and go straight from where you are today to your goal immediately, because you didn't have to have all these mistakes. And even though I hate to call them all mistakes, sometimes we just are doing it not the best way, and then we figure out, oh crap, I could do this better. So to avoid that and just go from starting point to doing it right the first time, there's nothing like that. It's the best of the best. So anyway, I love you. Thank you for all the YouTube comments. I'll be doing a video recapping all the most recent comments and answering questions through it, and I'll do that live. But I love you, and go change your life. Change something. Have some fun. Make some money. I'll see you later. Bye.